Right. So when you see these things, a lot of these brothers fall into these women and they trap. Okay? That's what y'all understand. But this Bible is going to protect you from those things. Right. And vice versa for the sisters.
Right.
Okay? So when brothers come up and talk to you, try to give you that smooth talk, if they're not talking about the Bible, leave them alone.
Right. Okay?
Especially about the truth of the Most High, keeping the laws, statutes, and commandments of the Bible. Okay? Y'all must come back to true heritage who you are. Is that morning? Good.
Verse 3. Meet not with an harlot, lest thou fall into her sins.
Right. And that's what a lot of our people do.
Right.
Okay? They meet a harlot and they fall into her sins, man. Whatever her sins might be. Okay? Yep.
Use not much the company of a woman that is a single.
I say pan around, that means turn.
Least thou be taking with her attempts.
Right. Go to Ecclesiastes 15. 15 and 1. Sirach 15 and 1. Sirach 15 and 1. Okay. So like I said, we come out here every Saturday to what? To teach our people, man. Okay? Just the basic laws. Okay? What?
The book of Ecclesiasticus in the Apocrypha, Sirach, chapter 15. He that feareth the Lord will do good, and he that hath the knowledge of the law shall obtain her.
Right. Read it one more time.
He that feareth the Lord will do good.
So he that feareth the Lord shall do good. Okay? Mean when you fear the Lord and you understand the plight of your people, you have to come out here and teach your people the laws and statutes commandments of the Most High.
Right.
That's what's good to do to your people.
Right.
Okay? When you read the Bible, it talks about that. Okay? Give me that in I think it was Nehemiah I want you to get out. I think it was 1 and 8 or 8 and 1. I think it's 1 and 8. What?
And he that hath the knowledge of the law shall obtain her.
So he that has the knowledge of the Most High shall obtain her. Just like the Sabbath day. We're talking about the Sabbath day. Okay? That you must keep it holy. Okay? You must keep the Sabbath day holy. Meaning not don't buy or sell on the Sabbath. Because the Latinos are not keeping the Most High's laws. Okay? I got it. Go to Nehemiah. About the prophets, how they went out and taught the people. You got it? I think it's... Is it 8 and 1? What?
Book of Nehemiah, chapter 8, verse 1. And all the people gathered themselves together as one man into the street that was before the water gate. And they spake unto Ezra, the scribe, to bring the book of the law of Moses, which the Lord had commanded to Israel. And Ezra the priest brought the law before the congregation, both of men and women.
Oh, that's what we do. We bring amongst our people to show our people, okay, the men and the women, okay, according to the Bible. Just like our forefathers did back then. Yep.
And all that could hear with understanding upon the first day of the seventh month. And he read therein before the street that was before the water gate from the morning until midday.
So from the morning until the midday, they read the Bible openly to the people, to teach the people, like we're doing today.
Right.
Okay, yeah.
Before the men and the women, and those that could understand, and the ears of all the people were attentive unto the book of the law.
Unto the book of the law. Give me Ezekiel 22, or did you have something?
And Ezra the scribe stood upon a pulpit of wood which they had made for the purpose, and beside him stood Mattathiah and Shema.
Right. So when you read, it talks about all the names, the men that were standing on his right hand side and all the men that were standing on his left-hand side. The same exact thing. Okay? So that's how forefathers did. So this is nothing new. Did not who you call Jesus Christ, did he not go out and teach the people also in the street? He wasn't in no pulpit. He was out there street, what, teaching the people.
Right.
Okay? Now we're doing the same exact thing that he's doing. Okay? I'm trying to find that verse.
The book of Ezekiel, chapter 22 and verse 26. Her priests have violated my law and have profaned my holy things. They have put no difference between the holy and profane.
Right. So those so-called pastors, okay, have you showed what is holy and what's unholy amongst our people? Okay? What?
Neither have they shown difference between the unclean and the clean.
Right. So they haven't taught our people about the dietary laws. When you read Leviticus chapter 11, it tells you about the dietary laws. Okay? You so-called niggas and Latinos. It tells you don't eat shrimp, crabs, okay? Why? Because the Most High tell you that you so-called Negroes and Latinos are holy people, okay? That you are the biblical people, you are the Israelites, according to the Bible, okay? And you must wake up to your heritage of who you are, okay? Like I said, we come out every Saturday to what? To show our people, okay? What? The truth according to the Bible, okay?
And have hid their eyes from the Sabbaths, and I am profane among them. Here, princes, in the midst thereof are like wolves.
And that's what they are, like wolves, okay? Y'all worshiping on the wrong day, which is Sunday, okay? That's why it says you are hating yourself for my Sabbath days, okay? So when you get up in the morning, you're gonna wake up and go to church on Sunday, okay? Worshiping the Most High, what? On the wrong day. Okay? Give me that, what you got? You got something?
Like wolves ravaging the prey to shed blood and to destroy souls.
Right, and that's what they're doing, to destroy souls amongst our people, keeping our people docile. Okay? That's why I say, man, every Saturday we come up here to teach our people. Any questions you want to ask, come up and ask us.
Right.
We're out here for our people.
Right.
Okay?
That's
when,
right.
When you ask us, it's going to be written out of the Bible. Okay? Yeah.
The book of Titus, chapter 3 and verse 3. For we ourselves also were sometimes foolish, disobedient, deceived, serving diverse lust and pleasures.
So even ourselves, before we came in the truth, we were just like y'all, okay? Destroyed, mentally, okay, go ahead.
Living in malice and envy, hateful, and hating one another?
Right, and that's what we doing before we got in the truth, okay? You don't know what our lifestyle before we got in this truth. Some right. Guys could have been big time drug dealers,
right?
Okay? But we changed our lives of coming what to teach our people, okay? But you gotta change. Yeah.
But after that, kindness and love of God our Savior towards man appeared, not by works of righteousness which we have done, but according to His mercy, He saved us by the washing of regeneration and renewing of the Holy Ghost.
Right, which is the Holy Spirit, okay? The renewing of the Holy Spirit. Okay? That's why Christ died for what? For our people to what? To come to repentance.
Right.
Okay? Not to keep doing wickedly, but to repentance of our people to what? To get right.
Right.
Okay? Yeah.
John chapter 14 and verse 26. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, He shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance, wheresoever I have said unto you.
Right, and this is your comforter right here. Give me that in Deuteronomy 4 and 6. This is your comforter, which is this Bible. Okay? That's why, look, sit down and read this Bible, man. Give me that Revelation 1 and 3. Okay? When you go to churches, man, even the first chapter tells you, this is what the first verse tells our people in the first chapter, right?
The book of Revelations, chapter 1 and verse 3. Blessed is he that readeth and they that hear the words of the prophecies and keep those things which are written therein. For the time is at hand. Verse 4. John, to the seven churches which are in Asia, grace be unto you and peace from him which is, and which was, and which is to come, and from the seven spirits which are before the throne, and from Jesus Christ, Yahawashah, who is the faithful witness, and the first begotten of the dead.
Right. Go to verse Revelation 2:27. Okay? See, this is what y'all understand. They read that verse, but check out the second verse of the second chapter, what Christ is going to do to you so-called niggas and Latinos when you get your mind right. Read.
The book of Revelations, shut up. Revelations chapter 2 and verse 27. And he shall rule them with a rod of iron.
Guess who's that rod of iron is? That rod of iron is you so-called niggas and Latinos.
That's right.
Okay, what?
You know, just kind of show.
As the vessel of a potter shall they be broken.
Then to a couple of minutes, you know,
two shivers.
Hand that way, you know, down.
Even as I received of mine.
Somebody stop or talk.
Was that verse 26?
Show them a little bit, you know.
Yeah, 26, 27, that's wrong.
The book of Revelation, chapter 2, and verse 26. And he that overcometh and keepeth my words unto the end, to him will I give power over the nations.
Did you just read that? You so-called niggas and Latinos? Read one more time.
And he that overcometh and keepeth my words unto the end, to him will I give power over the nations.
So if you so-called niggas and Latinos keep this word, he's going to give you power over the nations.
That's right.
Did he not give that to our forefather King David?
Let him know.
Okay. Read one more time so we can understand.
The book of Revelations, chapter 2, and verse 26. And he that overcometh and keep my word unto the end, to him will I give power and overcome the nations.
So he's going to give power over the nations. Okay? Give me that in Psalms, I think it's 2:1, with King David. He said the same thing to King David. Okay? A so-called black man. Okay? He said the same to King David. If you keep my words, I will set you on high above all nations. You got that?
The book of Isaiah, chapter 61 and verse 6. But ye shall be named the priests of the Lord. Men shall call you the ministers of our God. Ye shall eat the riches of the Gentiles.
What?
Ye shall eat the riches of the Gentiles.
Meaning the other nations, man. When the Most High bring us back forth to who we are, we're going to eat the riches of the Gentiles of the nations.
This is the word of the Lord of hosts. I took you from the pastures and from following the sheep to be priests over my people Israel. I have been with you wherever you have gone, and have destroyed all the enemies in your path. I will make you a great name among the great ones of the earth. I will assign a place for my people in Israel. There I will plant them, and they shall dwell in their own land.